Waqf and Ibtida. When you begin to recite the Holy Quran, you'll realize that many often times some verses run more than one line, sometimes three lines, two lines, and you wonder, how can I recite this entire verse within one breath? Well, there are symbols in the Holy Quran which help us with this. Especially if Arabic may not be our mother tongue, it's easy to dissect these verses and to recite them in a way in which the meaning and the translation of the Quran is not changed. Now, for example, many oftentimes most of the Qurans that we recite are based on the Uthman Taha script, and there are these numbers, rather letters, on the verses which help us with this. For example, at the end of the verse, there's usually a symbol with a number in them. This resembles or represents the end of a verse, which is pretty much self-explanatory. Now, in the case where you may see a small meme, this is known as a waqf al-lazim. This indicates that the reciter must stop at this point and take a pause before beginning again. For example, in Surah An'am, verse 36, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
إنما يستجيب الذين يسمعون والموتى يبعثهم الله ثم إليه يرجعون.
الوقف جائز, or the little jim you see on top of the verse. In this scenario, this indicates that a certain concept is complete and a new one is about to begin. Although a stop isn't obligatory, there is a possibility for it. And we see in many verses in the Holy Quran, within one verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses so many different topics in just one verse, even though it may stretch many lines, but still within one verse. For example, in Surah Al-Kahf, verse 5.
مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ وَلَا لِآبَائِهِمْ كبرت كلمة تخرج من أفواههم إن يقولون إلا كذبا.
الوصل أولى, or the little صلي that you see on top of the verse. In this case, it is better to continue. However, you may pause here. For example, Surah An'am, verse 17.
وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ وَإِن يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ.
الوقف أولى, with a little قلي you see within the verse. In this case, it is better to stop. However, you may continue. For example, Surah Imran, verse 75.
يَخْ يختص برحمته من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم.
Sometimes you may see a little la. Within this example, you should not stop. There's a possibility that the meaning may be changed. However, if it is located at the end of the verse, it is permissible to stop. For example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 25.
وَبَشِّرِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ كلما رزقوا منها من ثمرة رزقا قالوا هذا الذي رزقنا من قبل وأتوا به متشابها ولهم فيها أزواج مطهرة وهم فيها خالدون.
And lastly, المعانقة, or the two pairs of three dots within the verse. Now this is a rare example, but there are a few famous ones. In this case, you have the option to either stop at the first pair or the second pair, but not both. For example, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 2.
ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبِ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ.
Or another way of doing it,
ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَلِيُّ الْعَظِيمُ.